Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. This is the 13th tutorial of STAAD.Pro. In this tutorial we are going to discuss about supports. In previous videos we created our structure and we provided cross-sectional property to our structure, and now it's time for supports, so let's talk about it. Before applying supports, let's talk about the definition of support. Support restrain a structure at a point or a node. Any node of a structure can have six types of movements. It can move in X, Y, and Z direction. And then we get the reactions Fx, Fy, and Fz. Again, it can rotate about XY plane, YZ plane, or ZX plane. And in these cases, three types of moments produce. Those are MZ, MY, and MX. If it is rotating about XY plane, then we are calling it MZ moment. If it is rotating about YZ plane, then we are calling it MX moment. And if it is rotating about ZX plane, then we are naming it as MY moment. These six movements are known as 6 degrees of freedom. Once you restrain or stop any of these six movements, that will be support. To get support window, you have to go to this general option. I am clicking on it. In last video, we learned how to assign property to our structure, and in this video we will assign support to our structure. You can use this option to get the support window, or you can go to this option support page. When you click here, a window pops up and it is the supports window. You can create and assign supports from this window. Anyway, I don't want to use that icon. I will use this option. I am clicking on it. And that same window comes here. First we will create our supports, then we will assign them to our structure. Let's create some supports. I'm clicking on this create option. The first window you will get for fixed support. As we know, fixed support restrain all of these movements. Here we can see that all these movements have been checked as restrained, and we cannot edit or modify all these settings. This is default settings for fixed support. So the next step is using the add option. I'm clicking on it and I can see my fixed support in this list, and this is the icon of fixed support. Let's go for the next support. I'm clicking on create option, and the next one is pinned support. In case of pinned support, all kind of movements has been used as restrained and all kinds of movements have been released, and this is the default settings. We cannot change this, so I'm going for add. I'm clicking on it and I can see my pin support here as support 5. As I previously created some supports and deleted them, that's why the number has been started from 4 and 5. Let's go for the next one. I'm clicking on create option, and the next one is fixed butt. It is editable and you can create any kind of support from this option. You will not get any roller support by name, but you have to create one, and you can use this fixed butt option. Here you see the list of movements and this box are editable. You can check this box. If you want to release any of these movements, then you can click on this checkbox and your support will be created. Here we talk about release, not restrain. Let's release all but not FX and MZ. Then it will become roller support, and if you are using it as a spring, then you can input here the stiffness coefficient of spring. There is no name of roller support here. You have to create your own roller support by yourself, and you can use the option fixed part as I created just now. After creating, I have to add it, so I am clicking on it and my roller support is ready here. Let's go for the next one. The next support is being called as enforced. As you see, it is similar of fixed support, but there is a little bit difference with enforced. I am talking about this later. Enforced support allows displacement load. Sometimes we have a displacement load that doesn't make any change to our support, but there is settlement. In these cases, we will use this enforced support. We cannot edit or modify our enforced support, which is working as like fixed support. I'm clicking on add option and I can see my enforced support here. If I click here and go for edit, then it is not possible to edit, so it is default. I'm clicking on OK and I'm going for the next support. I'm clicking on create option and the next one is enforced but. Before doing that, I am going to discuss about the difference about enforced and the fixed. There is a little bit difference between these two supports. In case of fixed support, there is no settlement. But if there is settlement, then we will use this enforced support. I hope you got this point and I'm going for enforced but. As you see, this check and uncheck box is valid here. We can edit or modify our support from these boxes. Here we talk about releases, not about restrain. As we did for roller support, we used fixed but. We can use enforced but also. Let's release all but not FX and MZ, then it will become a roller support. I'm clicking on add. Then our support 8 number has been created, and if you want to edit this, then you can go there and edit that again. I'm not going to edit anything. I'm clicking on cancel option and I will go for the next one. Before doing that, let's talk about the difference with fixed but and enforced but. You can create roller support by both of these options. But if you have settlement, then you will use enforced but support, and if you don't have any kind of settlement, then you can use fixed but support, and you can import here the spring coefficient also. Let's go for the next one, and this is multilinear spring. It allows displacement and spring stiffness. When you know the displacement of the settlement and spring stiffness, then you can use multilinear spring. I'm not using it, so I will go for the next one, and that is foundation. You can use it for foundation, but there are a lot of better softwares to design foundation. You can use a special version of STAAD.Pro, that is STAAD foundation, or you can use SAP software for designing foundation. So leave it here, and the next one is inclined support. You can use this option for any type of support. Here you can see those list: pinned, fixed, fixed but, enforced, enforced but. But you will use only when you have a inclined member and inclined support. If your support is inclined with respect to a reference point, you can input the coordinates here and you will get that inclined support. And similarly, you can release your movements from this checkbox and you can input the stiffness of your spring. As I don't have any inclined member, so I don't need any inclined support, so I am not going to use it. The next support is tension or compression only springs. Some structures work as a spring as it provides tension or compression. In general, a spring will act in both ways. If you have tension in the spring, it will act against the tension, and again if it have compression, then it will act against the compression. In case of tunnel design, we can use this tension or compression only springs. Now I am not going to use it, so I have discussed all about these supports and I am going to close it now. And I have defined 5 supports here and I will assign them to my structures and I will use my nodes. There are 4 ways to assign our supports to our nodes. You can use any of these, but the first one is not valid now because I didn't select my nodes yet. So before using this option, I have to select my nodes. Let's go to my workspace and my cursor is now node cursor. I can select my node like this, and this option is valid now. Before assigning, you have to select your support, which one you are going to use. I will insert a fixed support in this node, so I will click on this support 4 and then I will go to select my nodes, then I will click on assign, then I will click on yes. Then you see there is a fixed support. Again, if I want to insert a pin support here, I have to click on this pin support first, which is support 5. Then I will use the third option, that is use cursor to assign. I will assign my nodes by like this, and then I go for assign, and then I will click on yes. Then you see there is a pin support. So this is all about support, and this is all for today. If you have any question or if you face any trouble, then please comment below, or you can use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing, see you in the next video.